Millions of pilgrims from within and outside Uganda on 3rd June flocked Namugongo, the site where majority of the convents were martyred in celebration for their bravery. Today we take you to Virika Catholic Church, where the animating diocese was flagged off. Sister Mora, the diocese communication officer who was part of the 300 choir team that was in charge of the vocals at the nationally celebrated event, said the celebrations were colorful and angelic.
We accepted it and we owned the thing. And that's why we made it successful by the singing, because people are really accepted that now the celebration is with us. Nobody else, it's only Fort Poto. And Fort Poto, who are these Fort Poto? It is us who have been chosen as choir members, because we had auditioning, we had it. In the little time, you had to do effort, like you are going to do exams. That's what we used. You are sitting the next week, you are having exams. So you have to do serious revision. That's what we did.
Sister Mora says their biggest challenge was the limited time of only 3 months that they had been given to train. She, however, admits this was a learning lesson for her and her team to always be prepared whenever such tasks come along their way.
Sing songs from different areas in order to allow our people to understand who have come. We had Swahili songs, we had Acholi, we had Nigerian hymns, we had Lukonzo, we had Nyankole. So these are not our languages for people. They are language from other people. How can we accommodate our people? At least we put a hymn that will help them understand that they are really in this mass. So it was a challenge in language, but it also helped us to learn.
Robert Kusemerera, the music director, also shared his experience on working with other music directors.
We're a big team of directors of music, personally here, personally from Fort Poto, and some other colleagues, music directors from Kampala. These directors are staying at St. Paul Major Seminary. That's where they are deacons and seminarians there. Then we also managed to get some other directors from Kampala to team up with us here in Fort Poto. So we came up with that product that we delivered at.
Teaching and training on the last week of March. So we spent two and a half months mm-hmm. to say that we present something, at least we submit something which people outside were expecting us. And we thank everybody in Toro, not only the Catholics, but every Christian, even.
During service led by Father Silvanus Barikurunji, the faithful were called upon to use their talents, just like the choir members did, to glorify God. He, however, expressed his displeasure at the rich people who have used the opportunity of high commodity prices to exploit the needy. He says such acts are not godly and should be avoided. This report was compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.